Hi guys, welcome to Adobe YouTube channel. In the last lecture, we studied about resistance, inductance and capacitance and derived the formula for energy stored by them and also solved some MCQs based on those concepts. If you missed that lecture, then first watch that. Link is given in the description below so that this lecture will be very clear to understand. Now, in this lecture, what we will do is, we will solve some more MCQs based on the concept of power and energy that have come in your SSCJ exam. And also, we will start the concept of magnetic circuit so that we will get a fair idea what type of question can be framed and how to tackle those questions. Now, let's start today's lecture. This is our first problem of today's lecture. In this question, it is saying there is a capacitor of 4 millifarad capacitance and a time varying voltage Vt is applied across it, and we need to find the energy stored by this capacitor from the interval T0 to t equal to 10 seconds. So, in my last lecture, I told you that energy stored by capacitance at any time t equal to given as E of t equal to half C Vt square. So now at time t equal to 0, the voltage across the capacitor equal to 0. Why? Now because time varying term has time, so multiplied with 0, result will 0. So energy stored at that instant will be 0. Now at time t equal to 10 second, so the voltage, time varying voltage will be 2 into 10 into sine 10. Remember, this is in radian. Okay, so after solving, we got minus 10.88 volt. And energy at that interval is half C V T square, V 10 square. Okay, half C is how much? 4 millifarad to 10 to the power minus 3, and 10 equal to minus 10.88. So this is square. Now, which is equal to, after calculation, we got 236.8 millijoule. Now, which is approximated to 237 millijoule. Now, energy stored by the capacitance at an interval T belongs to 0 to 10 second will be equal to E of 10 minus E of 0. It is very obvious that in the question we are asking about this interval energy. So this is 237 minus, and this is 0, so 237 millijoule. So your option A is your right answer. This is our second question. In this question, there are two heater are connected in series of rating 1000 watt and 250 volt across a 250 volt 50 hertz AC supply. Now we need to find the total power drawn from the supply. Now let me draw just the circuit diagram. This is let heater 1 and this is let heater 2, and these are connected to a AC supply of 250 volt and 50 hertz. Okay, now let I is the current drawn by these two heater. Now we know that power P dissipated across a resistance is given as P equal to V square by R. Now R equal to वी स्क्वायर बाय पी. सो पुटिंग दिस रेटिंग 250 वोल्ट एंड 1000 वाट वी गेट 250 इंटू 250 डिवाइडेड बाय 1000. सो 625 बाय 10 विच इज इक्वल टू 62.5 ओम. सो दिस ओम इज द रेटिंग रेटेड रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ ईच हीटर. नाउ इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई टोल्ड यू दैट इन सीरीज कनेक्शन करंट थ्रू ईच एलिमेंट विल बी सेम एंड द इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस इज द सम ऑफ टू एलिमेंट. सो the current drawn by the both element is given as I equal to V by R equivalent. Here V is given as 250 volt and R equivalent is 2 into 62.5 as each resistance value is 62.5. So from calculation we get 2 ampere. Now power drawn by H1 will given as, let's say PH1, power drawn by heater 1 is simply I square R of H1. Okay, so I square is 2 square and this one is 62.5 equal to 250 watt. Similarly PH2 will be equal to PH1 as they have same rating. So this is also 250 watt. Now P total, that is the total power drawn by H1 and H2 will be PH1 plus PH2, which will equal to 500 watt. So option B is your right answer. This is our third question. In this question there is an electric iron load with 500 watt and 200 voltage rating, and we need to connect this load to a supply of 240 volt supply. So how we can connect? We have to find it. In this question it is given as the P rating power equal to 500 watt and the rated voltage of the load equal to 200 volt, and here the supply voltage is 240 volt. Now from these two rating we can calculate the rated current. Rated current, we know that power by voltage equal to 500 by 200 equal to 2.5 ampere. Now rated resistance equal to V square by P, as we know that power equal to V square by resistance. So rated resistance equal to V square by power. So from that we got 200 into 200 by 500 equal to 80 ohm. See here rated voltage is given as 200 volt and the supply voltage is given as 240 volt. So as the supply is more than the load, we can directly put the load into this supply. If we put this load into this supply, then the load will get damaged. Why? Now because during manufacturing process there is a standard that the insulation of the load is designed based on this rated voltage. So as here the rated voltage is 200 and the supply voltage is 240, so we can't connect directly to this. So we need to do what? See, 240 voltage here is divided into 200 volt. This can be utilized for load, and 40 volt extra. This is extra, and this can be dissipated by any means. So we can use an extra resistance. Okay. So from that, now the current I equal to supply voltage divided by total resistance, let's say. Okay, so now here the total current, rated current is 2.5, means we have to flow this rated amount of current. to operate this load smoothly. So 2.5 equal to Vs is given as 240. Then R total is the R rated plus R extra. Now 2.5 equal to 240 divided by R rated is given as 80, and R extra we need to find. So now 80 plus R extra plus 240 by 2.5, which will equal to 96, implies that R extra equals to 96 by 80 equal to 60 ohm. So in order to operate this load by this voltage, we need to connect an extra resistance of 60 ohm in series with the load. So your answer will be option A. This is our fourth question. This is a very basic conceptual question and most important from your exam point of view. And last year this question came in your SSCJ exam paper. So in this question, it is saying there are two ball, one of rating 200 watt and 200 volt, and other has rating 100 watt and 200 volt. Let this one is V1 and this one is V2, and they are connected in series across a 400 volt supply. Now we need to find which ball will glow brighter. So proceeding further, let's know what is the concept behind this question. So always remember one thing: the ball with larger absorbed power, let PAB, will glow more brighter. So please remember this concept, and this is applicable to all the question of such type, means when the balls are connected in parallel, when balls are connected in series, and you are asking about to find which ball will be brighter. And remember one thing, in DC the power factor is unity, and the power absorbed by resistance is given as P absorb equal to V into I equal to V square by R equal to I square into R. So remember this thing, it will be helpful in your exam. Now we know that absorbed power PAB equal to I square R rated let, where I is the current drawn by both the ball B1 and B2, and we know that in series connection I is same through all element, and here the I is constant. Why? Now because the voltage is constant, that is DC, so the total current is constant. So here P absorbed directly proportional to R rated. Okay, this is one condition we derived. Now taking the rating of the ball to calculate the rated resistance, R rated equal to voltage square divided by P rated, means rated power. So here voltage is constant. Why? Now because B1 has a voltage of 200 and B2 has a same voltage of 200, so this V is constant. So here R rated is inversely proportional with P rated. So this is the second condition. Now from first and second, we can relate P absorbed is directly proportional to rated resistance, is inversely proportional to P rated. So by seeing this equation, we can conclude that the absorbed power is inversely proportional to rated power. So in that question, the rated power of ball 1 is greater than rated power of ball 2. So the ball 2 will be more brighter than ball 1. So your option A will be right answer. So always remember one thing, in series connection ball with lesser power rating will be brighter. So this is the gist of this problem. And this is our fifth question. In this question it is saying there are two ball of rating 230 volt and 60 watt and other is 230 volt 100 watt and these are connected in parallel across a main supply. So we need to identify which ball will glow brighter. See, this is a similar type of question to that of previous question. Here only difference is that two balls are connected in parallel instead of series. Here also the same concept is applicable, that is the ball with larger absorbed power will glow more brighter. So here I will calculate the absorbed power by each ball and compare between them to get which ball will more brighter. So let this is ball 1 and this is ball 2. I told you in my previous problem that power absorbed by resistance is given as P absorbed equal to V square by R, R rated. In my previous problem, I took absorbed power as equal to I square into R rated. Why? Now this is because in that problem, the two balls were connected in series. And we know that in series the current is same, so it will be easier. That's why here two balls are connected in parallel, so I take the absorbed power formula as V square by R rated. So here V is constant as it is in parallel connection, so absorbed power is indirectly proportional to R rated. We know that rated resistance is inversely proportional to the rated power. Why? Now see, we know that P rated means rated power is equal to V square by R rated. So this V is rated voltage and here V is constant, that is 230 volt for V1 and 230 volt for V2, so V is constant. So now R rated is inversely proportional to P rated. So by using these two relations, we can infer that P absorbed is indirectly proportional to R rated and directly proportional to P rated. So the ball with higher rating will be more power absorbed. Okay, so in this question the ball B2 has more power rating than B1, so B2 will be more brighter. So your option A will be your right answer. And please note one thing, that in parallel connection ball with larger absorbed power will be more brighter. Just remember this concept so that you can apply directly by seeing the option. In this question it is saying two electric balls have tungsten filament of same thickness If one of them gives 60 watt and other gives 100 watt, then we need to find the length of filaments. See, we know that the resistance of any conductor is given as R equal to rho into L by A, where rho is the resistivity of material and L is the length of conductor and A is the cross sectional area of the conductor. Here for two lamps, the rho is constant as the both lamps are made up of same material, that is your tungsten, and here the cross sectional area is also constant, as in question it is given that of same thickness, so A is constant. Now R is directly proportional to length. We know that power equal to V square by R implies that R equal to V square by P. Here, as we are comparing the filament length of two lamp, assume we connect the two lamp with equal source voltage. So here V is constant. Now R is inversely proportional to power. So write this relation here. So R is inversely proportional to power. Now by seeing this relation, we can tell that lamp with lower power has more resistance, that means has more filament length. So in comparison to 100 watt lamp, 60 watt lamp has longer filament length. So option D will be your right answer. This is a basic question from network conversion technique, that is star network to delta network conversion technique. And here the each phase means RA equal to RB equal to RC is given as 5 ohm, and we need to find RAB equal to RBC equal to RCA will be how much. So this is a standard formula, and when you are converting star to delta network, then RAB equal to RA plus RB plus RA into RB by RC. Similarly, you can remember these two formula as well. So putting this in this value, we get 5 plus 5 plus 25 by 5, so which is around 15 ohm. So answer will be your option D, 50 ohm. This is a very standard basic questions. Here generally the admittance is represented by Y equal to A plus JB, where we need to find what is A. Generally the impedance is represented by Z equal to R plus JX, where R is the resistance and X is the reactance. Similarly, the reciprocal of this is given as Y, that is admittance, equal to A plus JB, where A is conductance and B is susceptance. So in this question, your B is the right answer. This is a question from magnetic circuit. Here we need to find what is the unit of permeability. So in my last lecture I told what is permeability. It is the ability of magnetic material to permit magnetic flux. So suppose let consider there is a magnetic material, let's say this one is magnetic material, which is also called as core or electromagnet. Why electromagnet? Now because when we flow current, then it acquire magnetism. That's why we call this as magnetic material, also electromagnet. Let I wound a coil like this, and let's say I is the current flows through it. Now we know that when current flows through it, it produces magnetic field, and because of this magnetic field, there is some field lines which is nothing but our magnetic flux like this. So these are magnetic flux, which is represented by phi, and the unit is your Weber. Okay, now and let the winding has n number of turn, capital N number of turn. Now there is a term associated with it, that is your magnetic field intensity. That is represented by H, and H is given as your MMF divided by length. That is MMF for unit length. MMF is nothing but ampere into turn by length. That is means that is your current and number of turn by length. And also there is another term associated with it, magnetic flux density, which is represented by B equal to flux per area, where flux is Weber and area is meter square, its unit. Means suppose if you consider the magnetic material as a system, and the input here will be the MMF or simply current or simply H, that is magnetic field intensity, and the output is your magnetism, that is your magnetic flux density B. So the ratio of these two, that is the gain of the system, that is the property, it is a property of that system, that is mu, permeability, is nothing but B by H. So this is a gain, output by input. So this represent how the core is well, how the core is well towards magnetic flux. It explained that thing. So from that, mu equal to B by H. So we know that B has a unit, Weber per meter square, and also H has a unit, ampere turn by meter. So cancelling this term, meter, and the final will get Weber per ampere turn into meter. So option C will be your right answer. This is a very basic question from magnetic circuit. Here the permeance is analogous to which quantity? See, permeance is exist in magnetic circuit. Let me compare this first. Here permeance is exist in magnetic circuit only, and which is analogous to your conductance in electrical circuit. Permeance is the reciprocal of reluctance. Similarly, conductance is also reciprocal of resistance. So permeance means it is the ability, means it is a property of magnetic material to allow the magnetic field, that is magnetic lines of force, that is your flux. So in exam point of view, you may be asked what are the unit of this quantity. So let me tell the unit of this quantity. This is very important. We know that MMF in magnetic field is nothing but equal to the flux into reluctance, just like your Ohm's law, that is your MMF equal to current into your resistance. So here reluctance is represented by this symbol R equal to your MMF by flux equal to MMF is nothing but ampere turn. This is ampere turn and flux is nothing but Weber. So unit of reluctance is ampere turn per Weber. Similarly, the unit of permeance is Weber per ampere turn. So this is very important from your exam point of view. So here in this question, the right answer is your conductance, option A. So this is all about today's lecture. In my next lecture, we will solve some more problem regarding magnetic circuit. Then after that, we will start a new chapter called electric circuit. By this, let's wind up today's lecture. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you in my next video. Till then, keep watching and keep learning. And one more thing, please subscribe to our channel and like the video. And if you have any doubt, then put your doubt in the comment section. Thank you.